Have you ever felt disappointed? Have you ever been disappointed? Have you ever experienced a disappointment? I'm sure most of you are going to say yes, because somehow it's part of our human experience that we go through disappointment. And now you could be disappointed because you went to the supermarket and they didn't have your favorite brand of soap that you wanted, or they ran out of, you know, your favorite food. But then there's other disappointment that can be almost soul destroying. Disappointment that can really affect our well-being and how we feel and our emotions. And today on Monday Moments with Fran, I really want to delve into this topic in a little bit more detail, because I think it's an area that we all need to be mindful of. A couple of years ago, I watched an amazing teaching by Pastor Stephen Furtick on offenses, and he's a really practical teacher, and I love that he uses like a lot of objects and like almost role play to demonstrate his teaching. So he had this newly married couple on the stage, and he had a plant, you know, where you plant plants. And basically he was sharing an example that in the lady's family, growing up, they really celebrated birthdays in a massive way. Like in the morning, the family would all wake up, sing happy birthday to her, and it would be a big celebration. She'd have a cake and she would just feel really, really good. And in her husband's family, when it was their birthdays, it was a more low-key affair. It was like, yeah, happy birthday. But there was no cake and there was no singing. Everyone just kind of got on with their day. And so in their first year of marriage, on the morning of the wife's birthday, she wakes up and is expecting a cake and a celebration and to be sung to. And the husband just says, oh, you know, happy birthday, and gets on with his day and goes to work. Now she is left disappointed. So in the sermon that he was teaching, he then says, you know, that one little thing can be like a fence. So he gets a plank of wood and he puts it inside this planter as like a bit of a barrier between the two. And he begins to explain that over the weeks and the months and the years, when something happens that we are not expecting, or when something happens that is disappointing, it becomes like a fence and people feel offended. And it can be a barrier. Good morning. It's echoing on my side. Oh, okay. Hopefully it's the sound is going to be clear for everybody else. Sorry. Not sure what's that's happening. And so in a nutshell, he was teaching that we can be so offended and we can become really hurt and have disappointments because we have a lot of unexpressed expectations. And I think that's true for a lot of us. We can go through life and we can be in relationships and we've not expressed an expectation. And so we get upset for when somebody does something or they don't do something that we need them to do or not to do. That really aligns with kind of where we're at, and it creates healthy boundaries. And so the encouragement this week is really about communication. And communicating our needs and being able to be vulnerable and raw enough so that we can communicate expectations rather than feel offended, feel upset, and feel massively disappointed because of somebody else. Because we've assumed, well, of course they know I want this done, or of course they know that's not helpful or that is helpful. You can have known somebody your entire life, but every single season is a new season. You know, we change, we grow, we develop. And so also our expectations change, grow and develop. And it's really, really important that we are able to express those to people and everyone's really clear on what we need to happen or what we need to stop happening. And in that way, I believe that it'll really help us to have healthier, more meaningful relationships. Because although somebody may not intend to be hurtful, harmful, to disappoint you, to offend you, it can happen because they may not realize something, you know. And although people don't intend to, there is an impact at times. But we can each take responsibility and really make sure that we express our expectations. And it's never a demand. It's never a, well, you must. But if we're in healthy relationships, we can share expectations. And if the other person is willing and able, surely they will meet those expectations. And so I really want to encourage you this week to do some self-reflection, to really look at areas where you are feeling a little bit disappointed or even massively disappointed, and consider what is it that you can do from your side to make your feelings, your expectations, your needs known to that other person. So stay encouraged. Don't forget to encourage somebody else. Stay safe and stay well. God bless you.